Good evening, stock traders, and welcome to Stock Traders Talk Radio here on this beautiful Tuesday night, September 11th, 2012. I am your host, STT. Joining me on tonight's program, I have Stock Sumo.
Hey, STT, good evening. How you doing?
I am fantastic, sir. How about yourself?
Oh, man, I'm doing wonderful. I'm really excited for tonight's show. Looking forward to learning the ins and outs of DD Amanda.
All righty. Also joining us on the program tonight, we have Mr. Cop.
What's going on, gentlemen?
How's it going there, Mr. Cop?
Loving it. What could be better?
What could be better? Well, what could be better is the actual thumb show up that tell me to go. Because I've been told that it went up, and I don't still see it. Still don't see it at all. But anyway, it's all good. And yes, as Sumo alluded to a little early on my opening here, that tonight we have a super special show lined up for everybody. We have on air live tonight the creator of DD Amanda, Mr. Hans. Hans, are you there?
I'm here, and welcome. I mean, thanks, guys, for having me, and I'm looking forward to the show.
Well, we're glad to have you on the show. I mean, we've been asked for months and months, how do you guys do it? What are your scanners set to? What's this? What's that? Well, I guess we're going to have to give our little secret away tonight. But yep. We're more than willing and more than happy to share this with all the traders out there. That is our goal here at STT Radio, to make successful traders out of everyone. So, without further ado, I believe Mr. Cop is going to help commentate about DD Amanda, and I'm sure that me and Sumo will have plenty of questions. So, let's go with it. Mr. Cop, start us off here, sir.
All right, well, the first thing I'm going to want to talk about, Hans, of course, is going to be the it's a sign-up site, correct?
Yes, it is.
And basically, what is the purpose of the site?
Just to be able to use DD Amanda, be able to find stocks before the herd, to do your own research on stuff, your own DD. It makes all that very easy.
Yep, I would agree. Find stocks before the herd and is really the key to DD Amanda. That's what makes it so effective. Not to mention, as we go through it, there's going to be a lot of tools that will that are employed here that help you do that. I don't know of any other platform that allows you to do this. I mean, many platforms have scanners and all that other type of stuff, but nothing quite like this. Is it a pay-for site?
Yes, it is. It's $60 a month. With a promo code, it's down to $50. Let me just introduce Amanda real quick here. Amanda is the most advanced OTC trading tool ever conceived. Nothing else out there even comes close. You know, I have people say, oh, I got equity feed. I can get all that. And I say, no, you can't. And most guys are out there just following the herd and hope they can eke out a few percentage points, you know. But Amanda's designed for a thinking trader, a guy that, you know, is willing to do the work and go out there and find something before anybody else. And if you want multi-bag winners, you have to find your own plays, and you got to get in at the bottom or close to it. Now, I've been trading for over 15 years, and in that time, I've learned some patterns. I've learned a lot of things. And I wrote Amanda originally. It was a desktop application. I wrote it for me. You know, I wrote it so I could find these things. And there's a long history of how it all came about, and it's on the website at the bottom of the FAQ page, ddamanda.com. You can read about it. And then it took about 6 years to get it to where she is today. I mean, she used to be desktop, and now she's online. And I keep it open all the time. I keep it open all day long. Somebody mentions a symbol, I pop it into Amanda, and I get an instant view of exactly what's been happening with his stock. And the biggest thing about it is dollars traded. You know, people talk about volume. Volume to me is absolutely meaningless. It means nothing. because unless you have a price to go with it, you don't know. You know, you don't know whether somebody's throwing $500 at this thing or $50,000. You know what I mean? And I would literally be blind without Amanda. I really would. I wouldn't know what to do. You know, so I'd be back. Go ahead.
It sounds like our follow the money philosophy, which, oh, by the way, we came up with because of Dee Dee Amanda.
Yeah, I'd be back following BB's board looking for, you know, trying to get in before everybody dumps. You know what I mean? Because, you know, yeah. It seems like, you know, guys don't stay in as long as they used to. I mean, they get their 20-30% and they're gone, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I remember the old days, but anyway.
Yeah, you're right. I don't know what I would do without it either. I will tell you this. You know what's odd is I use Dee Dee Amanda a lot. And most of the time when I use it, I hardly ever look at a chart. Yep. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Which is, you know, unusual compared to the way I used to trade. You know, I'm a big pattern trend Momo guy. But when you're looking for something for the day, right? I mean, you know how tricky that piece can be. But, you know, over a range of time, especially in the OTC market, all of these have very similar patterns for the runs. If you pick every stock that went 1,000, 2,000, 3,000% over a duration of a month or two, right? Now, I'm not talking about your shot one day and that was it because some crazy news came out. Pretty much they all have the same pattern. And you can see the trends, you can see the buying trends, you can see where it happened, where the bid support came in, what the range was. A lot of powerful tools from that aspect. Well, let's go ahead and let's pull up Dee Dee Amanda and let's pick a ticker and let's run through it.
Yeah, I'm gonna pick Mike Romeo Kilo, which did good today, and it's been an Amanda play for about a week now, and. You know, I totally agree with you, Cop, is the first thing I look at on Amanda, and she should be up on your screen, is over on the right side, you have 120 trading days of data. And the columns are, you have your date first, then you have your dollars traded, which again is the most important thing to me. Then the price you closed at on that date. And then you have something called FACT or Factor, which is a propriety indicator, which basically indicates amount of money going through this thing. And in simple terms, a factor of, like, if you look at MMRK on 8/28, had a factor of 119. And what that means, and it traded $1,900 that day. And what that means is it traded 119 times what it usually trades. Okay, so when a stock does that, you know, you want to perk up. The next column is your volume. Now, again, I said volume is meaningless. 135,700 shares traded that day. You know, that's nothing. Okay. Unless you look at the factor and go, wait a minute. And then you look at the dollars and you go, oh, okay, this thing traded, that's a lot for this stock. The next column is the low for that day, the high, and then two columns, whether it either went up or down. Over on, okay, let's say you pick, you've got this stock up, okay, and there's some other things. Down at the bottom right of the chart, you see the RSI for the last, now it's not updated for tonight yet, so this is as of last night, this is at before today. You have your RSI values there. On the far left, you have a series of buttons, okay? And these buttons will allow you to DD a stock in a heartbeat, okay? The first thing I'll usually do is I'll click the, on the very bottom, the last button is the iHub talk button. I'll usually punch that first. And if you push that button, it will open a new window. And you have to have an iHub membership for this, but it will show every post on every board on iHub with all 346,000 members that it has that mentioned this symbol, okay? Now, this is
boom.
Really important. Yeah, because this is really important because, you know, now you can say, okay, who's talking about this stock? And if you, let's pretend we went back in time to 8/28 and we looked at, we had Amanda up and we're looking at this 119 factor. And we're going, what the hell happened here? And then you go over to iHub and you see if anybody's talking about it. and you see nobody's talking about it, you go, again, and you go, now why did somebody buy $1,900 of this stock today? And this goes to insiders. Okay, this is one of the main reasons I wrote Amanda, is to find insider plays and pre-promo plays. And by insider, I mean, okay, let's say you got a company and something happened, something good happened, but nobody knows about it yet except for the people that do know about it, the insiders. Like, say you have let's say you're gonna have a reverse merger. So you got a shell. There's three entities that know that the merger is gonna happen: the guys that own the shell, the guys that are gonna merge into the shell, and the guys doing the deal. Okay, so that's three groups of people that know what's going to happen. Nobody else knows. So these guys, you know, they go home, they talk to their girlfriend, they talk to their wives, they say, hey, we're going to do this, blah, blah. They talk to their brother, their sister, hey, check out this. We're going to, you know what I mean? Just normal talk, and they go, well, maybe I'll pick some of this up, you know. And it won't be crazy, but you'll see little, you know, like $1,900 is a good value. You know, somebody will throw $100 at it, a couple hundred bucks, 500, whatever, on something that never has done anything before. Okay. And so this is what Amanda's designed to find. Now, on MMRK, this is an existing company, but they haven't, they don't file. They kind of like, they have a really great product. They do a hydraulic winch, they have military contracts, what have you. But anyway, something is going on here to the point where they're, you know, somebody's buying the stock. And when we really noticed it, I mean, we noticed it on 828, and, you know, we started watching it because there's some noise out there. You got guys out there, you know, trying to buy lotto tickets, and they'll throw some money at something, just hoping. But if it's consistently after that, there's, you know, more activity, then you know something's happening. And I think we started buying at 3 cents and 4 cents, and you know, we got in. And anyway, I'll talk more about that later. But getting back to the DD buttons on the left. Okay, so you have your iHub talk button that tells you what's iHub saying about it. Now, if you push that iHub talk button and you got Super C and some of these other guys, you know, talking all about it, you can kind of pass on that. I mean, you may want to do more, but what it means is that, okay, these guys are running this thing. Now, back on MMRK, if you look earlier than 828, you'll see little buys. You'll see, okay, somebody picked up 10 grand at 2 cents on the 14th. Somebody else picked up 1,000 on the 3rd. Back on July 19th, somebody picked up 105,000 at a penny and a half, between a penny 10 and a penny and a half. So, seeing these trades, you kind of know, okay, how many shares are out there and at what price. And if these guys bought, then they could conceivably, you know, when it runs, that's your competition. Those are the guys that are going to take profits, okay? And after those guys are out, now you got, you know, now you're hitting new traders, and it kind of gives you an idea. Like on this one here, there's not many shares out there that were bought, you know, prior to this run today. So the only real competition is, you know, the flippers and what have you. Going back to the DD buttons, you have your OTC markets button is the second, third one from the bottom. That'll take you immediately to, you know, Pink Sheets OTC markets, and it'll take you to the filings, so you see your filings. The tech indicators is a new one I just came up with. It just shows if there's any tech indicators. I don't know. Some people like stock scores and American bulls, and so there's buttons for those. And, you know, these buttons will open up a window, and you'll be already on the page for the stock. You don't have to do anything. You just push that button, and it pops up. You got Board Central, which is a conglomerate of all the message boards on the Internet that talk about stocks. You've got your symbol lookup in case you want to look up a company name or something. At the very top of the buttons, you have some chart buttons. You have your S chart button, which will open up stocks charts. If they don't have a chart, you got your P chart. You have your 1, 2, and 3 year charts. And you also have a full chart, which will give you, you know, guys like tech indicators and all that, and it'll give you all the indicators you could ever want. Below that, you got the no bias filings button, which is, I like No Bias Filings because they're all formatted really nice, and that's kind of a proprietary. Not many people know about that one. And of course, you can go to the SEC Filings, which is below that as well, and you can push your Yahoo News button and find out what kind of news is on there. There's also two buttons called Promo and News L, and you can push those buttons to see if there's any promos going on with this thing or if there's any newsletters. Anyway, that's the basics right there.
Basics? That's it. That's like, I mean, basics. Seriously?
Can I ask a question if you don't mind?
Sure.
The newsletter button, when is that updating? Is that as it goes out or, you know, 10 minutes?
Well, if you push it right now, I just pushed it on mine on MMRK and it says no stock newsletters found. So there's no newsletters that are covering this thing. This goes to stockreads.com, okay?
Okay.
It instantly pushes that up. Hang on just a second.
Like some of your big promoted plays, Mike, that have you know, tons of newsletters on them, they'll
all
come up.
Who the hell is Mike?
STT, that's right, that guy. The as soon as you if a stock that's been promoted a whole bunch of times with tons of newsletters and all that, as soon as you click it and you're on that stock, it will pop them all up. It's amazing, absolutely amazing. Okay. You can see, you can do pattern and trend off of, you know, I want to go back to where what Hans was talking about with the iHub talk, right? The key to Didi and Manda is because you're able to go back in time and see what was happening with the stock and when the money flow started to happen, you're able to match directly up to certain people on iHub.
Bingo.
Every single time you can match up, you can figure out what's going on, when they're posting, how they're posting, their routine, all the time. And you can nail almost everything, right? I mean, there's no secret to what we do, right? I mean, you know, many people out there probably think we're, you know, they're probably biggest promoters under the planet. And the reality is we're just catching their plays all the time, every single time. And just nailing them all over the place. And then couple that with the OTC markets and the certain things that you can do right away with the filings and everything else, it's super, super quick. So you're able to make very sound decisions in a very quick manner all the time, especially if it starts popping a little bit. And then you jump to your chart and you check and see what you got as on your resistance, what your support levels are and all that other stuff. But go ahead, Hans. Let's go to the next thing. When probably Nevada SOS, probably.
Yeah. Absolutely. You know what? I can DD a stock in less than a minute. You know, because I just push buttons. As soon as I push the button, I'll glance and see. Okay. Close that window. Go to some another button. Look at the filings, and you can literally a minute or two. You can have a stock fully DD'd. yeah, there's a couple of other buttons. There's the Nevada SOS button, which will take you to the Nevada Secretary of State. And, oh, by the way, if you hover over any of these buttons or any of these things in Amanda, a little tooltip will pop up and tell you exactly what that thing does or what it is, you know, just to make it easy. So Nevada SOS, you know, what is it, 80, 90% of OTC stocks are registered there. So you can go there and look at what the true authorized is. You can find out if it's been reinstated, what the latest amendments are. And then if it's not on Nevada, you can go all states SOS, and that's a complete list of all the secretaries of state, and you just click on their link to do that. There's also a help button at the very top between the chart and where it says Amanda, and that's a very detailed user manual for Amanda, and it also has all the latest changes and enhancements, and I'm adding stuff to this all the time. I mean, I just added the Golden Cross scan, and people say, yeah, I got a Golden Cross scan. I go, no, you don't. You got a Golden Cross scan, but you don't have an approaching Golden Cross scan, you know, where a Golden Cross is going to happen in, you know, a week or 3 days or whatever. And I mean, this gets into more detail here, but you can measure. It shows you, you know, how far apart the 50 MA and the 200 MA are on a Golden Cross scan. And I'm going to get into the scans next. You can tell it You know, you can scan for, okay, I want to look for golden crosses where the 50 MA is 20% below the 200. And then there's also a speed. In other words, how fast is it moving up? You know, so you can scan for that. I guess what's next? The scanner? Should I get into the scanner?
Well, before you go to the scanner, I'd probably talk about your chart and your what you got with the 100K.
Okay, I have a pet theory that I developed over, you know, it took a long time until finally the light came on. And I noticed a really, really strong pattern. And that is, if a stock ever trades $100,000, okay, she gets what I call superpowers, okay? And what happens is she'll trade $100,000 maybe on a run or something else, and she'll drop. Like they all do, they all go back down. And she'll drop a lot of times like 70, 80, 90% or more, okay? But invariably, she will bounce hard off of that, okay? I mean, it's not like, I mean, a lot of stocks, they go, they drop, and they hardly ever move again. But if it's ever traded $100,000 before, you got a lot of people in it, maybe some bag holders, I don't know, but it will bounce again. It will always, it'll move. And so you can scan for these, you know, you can scan for a drop back that has dropped like 95%, you know, or 90%. And, you know, you kind of look at them and see if they've kind of bottomed out or not. And then you can just get in and wait, you know, because it'll happen. Like a very high percentage of these, I call them drop backs. So that's what that 100K is. The times is the number of times they've traded 100,000. The days is how many days it's been since they traded 100,000. The change is, okay, what percentage have they dropped since then? And below that, you got a 10-day dollar K, which is also scannable. This is how many thousands of dollars has it traded in the last 10 days, okay? And like MMRK here, it shows 24. So in the last 10 days, it's traded $24,000. This is as of yesterday. And below that, you have your 20-day average dollars traded, which is $1,000 average a day. Anything?
I would let's cover the drag.
Oh, okay, drag is another proprietary indicator that I came up with. And basically what that says is how hard is it to move this thing? You know, how fat is she? I know, if this thing is being pushed, how hard is it to push her? And it's based on the number of dollars that it takes to move her a certain percentage, okay? Like MMRK here has a 2.18 drag, which is pretty low. A lot of times they'll have less than one drag, which means they'll move easy. And the comparison to that is how thin are they, okay? And like this one is, like, and it's the last 5 days, okay? So on MMRK, you'll see that it's 218 on the first, that was yesterday. But the bottom one, 0.47, that's like, it was real easy to move her there, okay? And that can either be red or blue. If it's red, that means how easy is it to drop her, okay? And ideally, what you kind of want, what's really good is if the red drag is high and the green drag is low. In other words, you know, she's got a lot of support. It takes a lot of dollars traded to drop her. You know what I mean? And if it's low green, it means it doesn't take much to raise her up. A good example on drag is, KMAG is really, I don't really want to say anything here, but if you push up KMAG, and you'll see the drag, I don't know about this one because there's a lot of money going through it, and the more money that goes through it, the more this drag indicator doesn't really apply that much, but you can see a high drag there, 729, which means it takes a lot of money to move her now, okay? It's like, on Monday, it took $140,000 to move her up 2%, okay? Whereas the day before, it took, you know, half that, $75,000, to move her 3%, okay? So that's just an example of, you know, drag going up. But like I said, it depends on the price. The higher the price goes, the it's really not adjusted. But it just gives you an idea how hard it is, easy it is to move it. I'm going to go back to MMRK. And should we talk? What's next? The scanner?
Yep, that's next.
Okay, the scanner. This is a very powerful scanner. You know, a lot of scanners, they say, okay, I'll let you scan for, you know, stocks less than $5, less than $1, blah, blah, you know. Amanda has a range, okay? You have a minimum price and a maximum price that you can zero in on it, you know, like a scalpel, like a, you know, magnifying glass. So, like on, let's do the insider scan. I don't know what parameters Siffy has, but let's do a minimum price of, let's go trip 03 on the minimum, and the maximum, let's go 0.01. In fact, we could even go lower than that, but let's just go 0.01. So our minimum price is trip 03, 0.0003, and the maximum is 0.01. So we're only going to, the scanner's only going to pick up stocks that are in that price range, okay? It'll skip everything else. The next column is dollars traded. Now, again, you have a range here. You know, you don't have like, okay, I just want stuff that's traded over $5,000 or less than $1,000. No, you have a minimum and a maximum. So you can dial in on what kind of dollar volume you're looking for, okay? And on an insider, like this is, I've got the insider scan up. We're going to run that one. Like on an insider, you're not really interested in stuff that traded $20,000 or $50,000, okay? Because on an insider, when they leak that information to their buddies and girlfriends and what have you, they're going to say, hey, don't hit it hard. Just, you know, just buy $100 worth, $200 worth, blah, blah. You know what I mean?
Yep.
So on the dollars traded minimum, I got $299, and on the max, I've got $9,000. Now there's another kind of insider scan that I'm gonna that I just recently became aware of, where you do higher dollars. You go up to like $30,000, because some of those are, you know, there won't be any talk about them, but all of a sudden they'll hit hard. And I think those are pre-promo plays. I'm not sure, but anyway, so a maximum of $9,000, minimum of $299, and on the factor, generally I've found that a factor of 11 is like a sweet spot that, you know, you won't miss any. And RSI, now you can scan on RSI. You can, my buddy, Scott, he loves the RSI scans, because he'll put an RSI in there like 30, and he'll only look at stocks that have an RSI less than 30. You know, he's looking for those low bouncers, those high, you know, bottom feeding type of shit, you know, stuff that has a lot of potential. You know, stuff that's really dropped. And so he likes that. So that's zero. Let's go zero on the RSI. And by the way, when a value is zero, that means that Amanda will just ignore it. It won't come into play. And below that, you have your 100K times. Now, this, again, is for the that dropback stuff. So that's going to be zero. The days is going to be zero. The 100K percentage change is zero. So those three fields are for the dropback, so I'll just leave those zeros. Now, the next field to the right of that underneath days is 10DY dollar K. Now, you can use that one. I'm just going to put zero in it. But that's your 10-day, you know, how many thousands of dollars have traded in the last 10 days, and you can do that. You can put something in there. Below that is your Golden Cross Delta and Speed values. We're going to leave those at zero. And that's it. We're not going to check anything else yet until we start scanning. Now, so basically we just have your price at trip 03 to 0.01. We're looking at stuff that traded $299 minimum to $9,000 maximum and had a factor of 11. In other words, it did 11 times what it usually does. So basically, that's it, okay? Now, down where the symbol is, it should have MMRK in there, down at the bottom left. We can go to the top of the database by just punching an A in there and hitting return on your keyboard. And this is the top of the database, A, which is, by the way, it's Agilent. It's a it's a New York Stock Exchange stock. That thing, when I was, this is funny, I mean, when I was first running this a few years ago, Agilent was way low, and it just kept going up. And every time I go to A, I kind of like look at it and go, wow, this thing's really doing good, you know. But it's NYSE, and Amanda is just strictly OTC. All right, so we're at the top of the database. So at the bottom of the scanner gray box, we have three buttons, and the one in the far right is called Next. And so we push that button, and we look, see what comes up. Now, if you guys have the parameters the same as I do, you should see BHMNF should be the first stock. Is that true?
Yep.
Okay, I don't really like foreign stocks, so I'm just going to push next and go to the next one. I think I'm going to put a flag in here, so you just skip them from now on. Let's look at the next one. So I'm going to push next. And what Amanda does, it walks the database, okay? It walks the database either up or down. Like, you can push the previous button to go back from any place you are in the database, but it'll go forward or backwards. And it'll stop at a stock that satisfies the scan criteria. Okay, the next one, it should be blue. BLEW should be the one that came up. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, this one got, this one on Friday or Monday, it traded $364 with a 26 factor, which means that it traded, you know, 26 times what it usually does, and it actually dropped 11% that day. You can kind of look at the trading history going back. This was a hot little runner a while back. This could almost be, it almost qualifies as a drop back. It looks like the most that it ever traded was 64,000 way back in April. So, you know, that might be, there might be something going on here. I don't even know what it did today. I'd have to bring it up if it did anything today. Blue.
Yeah, not today.
Yeah, she did pretty good back there. Ran all the way up to 80 and then came right back down.
Yeah.
Over time.
So, I mean, I don't think anything's happening here, but look, we can push the IHub talk button just to see if anybody's talking about it. This was pretty popular stock back in the day. I gotta do something here real quick. I don't know if anybody's talking about blue. I remember this one.
Yeah. They still got a lot of people talking about it.
Yeah. So it's not like an insider play. It's well known. So this isn't exactly what we're looking for. Yeah, there's a lot of posts on it today. Look at that. Okay, so let's go next. Let's look at the next one. And, okay, now you notice how the symbol isn't changing much. It's BLZ, LLZ is the next one. Now this is a 007. Oh, this one looks interesting. Look at that. No trading, hardly nothing. Okay, way back when in May, looks like it did some trading there. Was it a penny? Penny and a half. You can go down and scroll down and look at what happened there, but nothing recently. Let's go over to IHub Talk and see what IHub has to say about it.
Nothing.
Nothing. Okay, well, this one looks halfway interesting. I mean, on Thursday, somebody threw $500 at it, and on Monday, somebody threw $900 at it. So it might be something to watch. Like I said, there's a lot of lotto tickets, so you need confirmation. You know, guys just throw money at something, just hoping. But you can go through all the DD buttons and look and see if there's anything.
Hit ports. Oh, boy. Look at the fourth one that came up. CBJG.
Okay. Let me see.
You're going to like this.
CAPA, that's a popular one, so we can skip that one. Oh, yeah. This one. Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
Yep.
Look at that.
Yeah, but this one was a, I think this was a reinstate. Oh, what was this? Oh, I think Harry ran this one.
Yeah, but look, and you can go right back. And
Harry
you can
and the Hendersons? They caught Bigfoot?
All right, so let's kind of talk about this one for a minute.
Okay.
All right, what you're really looking for, right, is you're looking on 9-7, right? That you're going back in time, and you're going to look and see what's going on with that. All right, you see that very little buy-in at the 10, right? It was a quad stock. If you go all the way back in time, nothing, right? So what you got is on the 7th, it traded 13,000, right? Okay. So we pop in the iHub talk, and we're gonna go back to the 7th, and look who it was, Buttonwood and Pink Lawyer, right? So we're gonna go early into the day to see what's going on with that on 9-7.
Yep.
Right, and what you're able to do is you're able to see exactly when, how they do exactly what they do. So. H-Dog at 1 o'clock right there starts popping. It heads up on shell, file name, blah, 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 right? Yep. And then it popped quick, right? 120%. And you can run through and you can see exactly what happened here, right? And a consistent thing, if you notice, Super C seems to be on a lot of these plays that actually happened. Wayno, H-Dog, right? They're all over the place on this. And you're able to see the trend on a ton of stuff, right? That's a pretty good one right there happening.
Yeah. And you can even go back further in time. You know, I mean, it all started on 9-7, but you can go down further and bounce back. I use Alt-Tab to switch back and forth. You'll notice on 8:30, you got Gumza and Wayno 2 posting, and you notice that was the date that somebody threw $900 at it.
Yeah, absolutely. Let me grab a little.
You can, and you can even go back to March. Okay, well, these are just lists. Here's a guy on 223, NYR2 posted on 223. I don't think I go back that far. I go back to March 22nd. But yeah, you can match it up, you know. So, you know, but here's the interesting. Look at this, Cop. Look at 830. $909 traded. And 130 factor, that would have showed up on the insider scan on that day, and you could have just kept your eye on it, you know. And
nope.
Of course, there was no real follow up in the next 4 days. So, but then boom, on the 7th, it went bonzo. Yeah. And I think it even did good today. CBJG. In fact,
no filing since 2010. Caveat emptor. No information. I mean, they're running a stock. That's what they're doing.
And it's up 83% today.
Oh yeah.
Yep. So
you would have caught this. You would have actually on this if you ran your scan and you saw it that day, right? You would have bought this on the 7th, right? Yep. And the most you would have paid for it is someplace between 9 and 27. Right, you would now you're trading, your skill comes into play here. This puts you in the ballpark. Your next piece is trying to get to the pitcher's mound, to where now you're looking at the chart, you're looking at the action, you're looking at the L2, and at that point you pick your entry based off what's happening. You find your entry, right, and now you want to get to the rubber on the pitching mound, and now it's you plan your trade and you work your trade. And clearly, if you planned your trade and worked your trade based off of that, what did it close at today?
0055.
Yeah, that was an easy 400% right there. An easy 400%. Right? Because chances are you would have got somewhere around the 20, so maybe more like 140%. Huge gain, though. I mean, that one's simple. That was a very easy play.
Yeah, you could have actually picked it up at 20, 21, 22 or whatever and had a nice double today. But like I said, this isn't the true insider play. You guys want to see a true insider play? I mean, this is the poster child of all poster childs. Punch in.
Yeah, let's see it.
Punch in LaForza, Lima, Frank, Zebra Alpha. Now, this will show – I saved this one in Amanda. This is back from 2006. and I saved her for perpetuity. She's in there forever.
What's the ticker?
LFZA, Lima Frank Zebra Alpha, or Lima Foxtrot Zebra Alpha.
Gotcha.
You got that one up, Sifi? I hope you do it. All right, if you scroll down on that to
Oh my gosh.
Oh yeah. This was the all time. In fact, it was right around this time that because of this, it's a long story. We were doing something, me and some guys were doing something, but this is more or less how Amanda got her, this is the second evolution of Amanda came about because of this. Because of this stuff that happened on LFCA, and I'm going, wow, look at this. All right, let's go through it. A 926 out of the blue, a 3801 factor. This thing's trading at Trip 04, okay? Somebody threw $3,800 at this thing, all right? Just out of the blue, out of nothing. So if you were running Amanda back then, you would have perked up on this going, whoa, what's going on here, you know? And then, like I said, you have to verify, so you have to wait till the next day and see if there's any follow-up on this, or whether it's a lottery ticket. But with $3,800 going into this thing out of the blue, I think it's more than a lotto ticket. Somebody knows something, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Next day, $424, not much. Day after that, $5,800, and she's starting to go up too, okay? But she's still low. She's Trip 09 by 28. Next day, some more money, and money keeps flowing, and there's nothing. There's no news. There's nothing out there. It just, people might have been perking up at this point and saying, whoa, what's going on with this one? But there's nothing, okay?
Holy smokes.
And then, until people kept buying it. But look at that. Even up to, like, October 6th, you could have got 0040s, you could have got in at 005, you know? But then what happened on 10/11 on October 11th? Guess what they did? They announced a reverse merger of epic proportions. It was kind of like a soybeans to fuel type of deal. It was a big deal and traded $1.6 million, went up 1,000%. Okay, and. And it kept going from there until on 10/27 it had a high of 84 cents.
Okay. And you could have easily bought this at Quad 9, easily based off of indicators of what you were seeing from DD Amanda. Holy smokes!
Yep. You could have got in the next day at 8.
That's 85,000%.
Yep, it's insane. It's absolutely insane. This would have been a life changer. I mean, you throw anything at this thing, you can walk away a millionaire, you know, damn near.
No, that's absolutely awesome. Let's talk about your bottom. What do you got on right by the symbol to the right? Which ticker you want to throw in there?
What symbol to the right?
You know where you type in your symbol, and then you have the AS, the OS, and the float, and sometimes.
I don't know. Let's put in Let's put in JBII, my favorite rule, baby. If you put in JBII, now the ASOS float is not updated on all of these. On a lot of them, it has it in there, but it changes all the time, and I really haven't found a good source for it. A lot of times, Pink Sheets is off. I usually, you know, get it out of the filings. But the SOS, it shows what state it was you know, where it's registered at, Nevada. And then ASOS float is, now these are millions. So like on this one, on JBI, it's 150. ASOS is 90 and the float is 39. And also it gives you the tier level. Now this has got the Jolly Roger, got the, you know, CE, but it's also OTC QB. Where's another one? You pick a symbol, Cop?
MIKP.
MIKP. Let's look. Okay, yeah, we don't have the ASOS float in there. Here's another thing that it shows you. Below that, it shows you the history of the symbol, okay? Like way back when in 2008, this was EHDN, and they had a 1 to 500 reverse split. Then it was PINR. Then it was MIAKP. Then they got the D, which means they're doing something cool with it. So you can see the symbol history and the split history and all that.
Yeah, that's the big piece with that. You can always see the RSs, the whole nine yards.
Yeah. I'm working on getting the ASOS float. I think I got a line on an extract that I can plug that in. Whenever I see one, I'll plug it in. I have my own development version of Amanda that I use to, you know, update stuff like that. And but anyway, yeah, we can just go. But you guys get the idea on the insider scan.
Yeah. Oh yeah, absolutely.
And what else can we go over?
Well, talk about let's not run through a scan, but let's talk about what the scans are and what they're for.
Okay. All right. I have the very first one is called Main. Now, here's the thing. There's 12 scans in all. Now, you can make your parameters whatever you want. It's just when new people come on, it's certain set to certain default values, so just gives them a place to start. But like my first scan here is Main. And I think what I'm looking for here was huge runners, you know, in case you wanted to join in on a Momo play or something like that. You can find what the big runners are. And by that, you know, I do my dollars traded minimums, I think like 20,000, and the max is 99123456. You can look for stuff that traded over $100,000, for instance, you know. In fact, I'll just go through the rest of the scans.
All right.
So below that, you have a shell scan. But again, like I said, you can customize all these. Oh, okay. On the scanner, you have certain check marks. Like if you check the shells only box, it'll only show you shells, okay, that also match the other criteria. And back in the day, Chevy gave us a shell list, and it's a little bit out of date now. But a lot of the shells are still out there. They're flagged as shells. A lot of them, you know, some of them have not shelled anymore. But you can search. You can just look at shells, the shells that are still out there, and see if there's, you know, anything going on there. You have your Golden Cross checkbox. Now, what that does, there's two ways to search for Golden Crosses. You can either use your delta and speed, which is, okay, how far apart are the 50 and the 200 MAs? And that's your delta. You know, you can put in 20% or 10% if you want to dial in. And the speed is how fast are they closing? In other words, how fast is the 50 MA moving up to the 200? In other words, how soon is it going to happen? You know, and a lot of people love golden crosses and go by them. So that's. But if you put a checkbox in the golden cross check, then you're just going to see golden crosses that are within 2%, in other words, that are like happening right now or will happen tomorrow or will happen very soon or may have already happened, you know. And so that's the golden cross. And then over below the RSI on all the stocks, you see golden cross data. And basically this is your 50 MA as related to the 200 MA. Like on GX Delta, like on MRPI we're on? MIKP, hang on.
MIKP.
I hit the next button. Let's go to MIKP. Okay, like on MIKP, your DX, your 50 MA is already above the 200, so it's already above, okay? And it shows the direction is up. In other words, it's moving up. The 50 MA is moving up. The speed is 1, which means it's not moving very fast, and it's 58%. There's 2 days here. 58 is today, and 57 was yesterday. And so yesterday was 57% above. Today it's 58, so it's still moving up. So that tells you what the 50 MA 200. I'm going to be adding some quicker SMA. Guys that know about SMA crossovers will like this. I think there's a 5 and a 13 day that provides an early signal on stuff. So I'm going to throw that in. I'm always thinking of new stuff to put in here.
I got something that needs to go in here.
Okay, go ahead.
Your chat button.
Oh, that. That is an ongoing saga with that chat. I put it in there one time. Somebody said, I can't remember who it was, but right now I don't even know what it's doing. I think that they went down. Or
I could tell you this, that I think the STT chat, that would be a good spot for that to go.
Absolutely. I'll hook it to that. No problem. Yeah. Because I've been looking for a chat. You know, guys want to chat. Yeah, let's do the STT chat in there. Hell yes. Good, thanks. Good idea.
It's a win-win.
Here to help each other, man. Believe me,
Absolutely. I'm curious of something. The STT's promotion code. We probably should tell people that, huh?
Oh, yeah. STT233. Let me double check that.
STT233. Now, what does that do for people that want to sign up?
That saves them $10 a month.
It makes $10 a month.
$50 saves them 20% or whatever it is, 18. Yeah, it knocks $10 off the monthly price, which is pretty cool.
Very cool.
Let me double check what. I know what I'll do here. I've got all these tools here. Let me double check what that promotion code is for you guys.
But amazing, amazing capability. I mean, I use this every day, and this is what helps me.
You know, I got to be absolutely honest with you. This thing is so powerful that I don't even know all the capabilities of it, and I wrote the damn thing. You know, yeah, that promo code for STT Radio is STT233, Sierra Tango Tango 233, lowercase, uppercase, it doesn't matter, just put lowercase. Oh, I want to mention something about MMRK. Speaking of, you know, I don't even know what, you know, what's a guy named NVIDIA for Games is the guy that found MMRK. Running some kind of a scan, and he came across it, and then he emailed the company, and just serendipity, they go, "Oh yeah, we're going to be releasing some news soon." He goes, "Whoa," you know. So he posted that in our room, and I'm going, "Oh, okay, hang on just a second, I got to put a buy in."
Those are always nice when you get those, right?
You know, we now, all bought it, and you know, we're all making out pretty good on it. So, but yeah, NVIDIA, two games or four games, I think it's four games. It's a collaborative effort. You know, we all help each other, and we want to make money, and we want everybody to make money, you know.
Absolutely. Now, when do you update it daily?
In fact, I'm updating it now, and I'm kind of like kind of behind the eight ball a little bit. I don't get the end of day data until 7:30 my time, which is 5:30. I don't get it until 8:30 your time, Eastern time.
Okay.
So that means I can't update it until then. But I usually have it updated by 9:00 Eastern time. And I'm a little bit behind tonight because I'm talking, walking and chewing gum at the same time. In fact, I'm updating it right now. And I just, you know, I tried to get it earlier.
So normally 9 p.m., 9:30 p.m. at the latest, around there?
Yeah, very latest 9:30 p.m. I have it done by about 9 or a little bit after 9. It's going to be a little bit late today.
Now, one thing that I probably should mention, too, is especially for the listeners and new subscribers and all that, you pretty much help everybody with how to use the system one-on-one. Now, I know for a very, very long time you kept DD Amanda to a very select group of people, and now you're opening up a little bit. And, probably what's your cap that you're probably going to go with, 100 traders maybe?
I don't know. You know, if we get too many users, I'm going to have to get a dedicated server because, you know, too many people be hitting the database. And, you know, originally this was I just had this design for me and my buddies, you know. And, sure. You know, then I said, well, you know, why not open it up? And so, you know, It's a hell of a tool, and so yeah. Right now, I wear t-shirts.
That's one way to go.
This is really cool stuff, man. I'll tell you what, I've been in the dark on this Didi Amanda stuff. I've relied on, you know, my other scanners that I have, but now that I'm starting to get acquainted with this better, this is really cool. Cop, I have to be honest, I'm a little bit jealous that I haven't taken the time, and you know, you have all this amazing knowledge.
It's amazing. Yeah. It takes a lot of fundamental analysis out of stuff, and it does take a lot of chart work. It just gets you directly to the ball field and on the pitcher's mound. And then now your trading skills and who you are and how you trade, then that comes into play. You look at what you're looking for, you see the players, you see the certain trends, you see certain things, and then based off how you trade, you can do that. But it puts you there before the herd, exactly like Hans started this thing off with. Before the newsletters, before all the things, before the runs and all that other type of stuff, this is what it does. And that it positions you for the game with a great seat for it. So that's huge. Huge.
Yeah, you know, there's other scans too. You got your death drop scan, you got your bottom scan.
Based off what type of trader you are, sure.
And I haven't mentioned AK Spy yet. AK Spy is the most amazing thing ever. And right now it's free with Amanda, but it won't be for very much longer. AK Spy looks at all the AKs in real time and scans for key phrases like reverse merger, forward split, that kind of stuff. And it will send an email alert out to you instantly, and you go from there. And
it's you know what I did with that, Hans? Hans, on my second day with AK Spy, and this was a while ago, right? I wanted to see how fast it was. So I probably got, over the course of a day, about 20 8K Spy emails, right? Real time, goes directly to my email. As soon as I got it, I went to the link, copied the link, went to the iHub board, and posted it, right? As soon as I got it. I wanted to test how long it took somebody else to either post it or respond to it, right? And I was beating it so fast, it was unbelievable. Nobody even came close to touching me. Not even the regulars who were on the stock all the time. Not one.
It's the time frame that you get it from when it hits the SEC site is seconds to at most 2 minutes, somewhere in there. And, you know, I have people ask me, you didn't get this to look at. The system is totally automated. I get it at the same time everybody else gets it. There's no, like, I don't sit here and pre-scan them or anything. I don't have time for it, you know. So it's a totally automated system. It's running on a separate little server I got, and it just goes ahead and does its thing every day. So if you want something and get clued in. In fact, there was one just recently, AK Spy, that did awesome. November Charlie.
Yeah.
I got an alert on that. Oh, and you can configure those. You can configure those by price now, okay? I mean, if you don't want to see any stocks, if they're Amanda, then it'll pull up the price for you in the tier level, give you a lot of good information in the email. But, like, if you're only interested in pennies or less, which I am. Anyway, this thing, alert came up. I looked at the AK, and it said this guy had just gone to court and took over the shell. I'm going, woo, you know. So that one ran pretty nice. Let me look at that one real quick. What happened with that one? This was this wasn't too long ago. This was this was on 8/8, and it ran. Oh crap! Look at this. It ran 1,400% that day.
Mm-hmm.
$58,000, and I was in way early. Our boys were on way early on this too.
Absolutely awesome.
We've made really good bank on that. So like I said, for right now, you get the AK Spy, but that's going to change probably within a few days. So
let me ask you this. Would you be able to set a scanner to pick up Form 4s and insider buying?
Sure. But, somebody else said that, but there's so much noise there. you know, even with the AKs, I mean, there's thousands of AKs or hundreds get filed every day. And, you know, you'd have to put something else in there. I mean, you can watch the SEC side if you want to watch those. But here's the other thing: is a lot, the SEC site doesn't give you the symbol; it gives you the name. So now you got to look up the name and find out what symbol you're talking about. You know, yep. So that's all done for you with AK Spy. I do want to maybe. There's another one I'm working on is S8s, and the things that I'm gonna be putting in here is the I've got a really cool idea for S8s and S3s. It's gonna be awesome.
Don't give out all the secrets.
No. I've got a new scan in the works called the Bonzo Gonzo scan. This is going to be amazing. This is another pattern I've noticed that has a pretty high percentage of runners, you know. And that's going to be awesome. I'm working on that right now. So.
Well, Hans, absolutely awesome. You know, we all use it, and it is the benefits to the account have been ridiculous, and I will never trade without of it. And you know, those of you listening in the listening audience, and the promo code is STT233, and the website is ddamanda.com, and you can sign up for it. How much is it again, Hans?
It's $60 a month without promo. With promo, it'd be $50 a month, and you can get a semi-annual and get it down to like $43. And if you buy a year, it goes all the way down to $41. And you know, I want to say one.
Yeah, go ahead.
I want to say one thing. You know, Amanda looks kind of intimidating at first. I mean, you look at this and you go, "What the hell?" You know, and people go, "Wow, this is so weird." And it's not. It's very, you know, just spend just an hour or even less, just a few minutes, you know, read that help file a couple times, and it'll all make sense. I mean, knowing, it's like you said, I don't look at charts so much anymore. I don't either. I look at this column of trading, and I can see exactly what happened. It's like, you know, the Wizard of Oz. It's like looking behind the curtain. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
No, that's who you remind me of. You remind me of Oz.
The Wizard of Oz, yeah.
People are wondering out there who's behind the curtain. It's Hans.
Yep. It is good stuff.
All right, very, very well done there, Hans. And I'll give you this much: if Cop can use it, anybody can.
There's some truth to that, Matt. He's not bullshitting on that either. That is very true. I'm not a very technical guy.
Good stuff. Awesome. There, Hans. We'll have you come back on in a month or two when you update. So whenever you update something, give us a hit, and we'll get you back on and show us the updates that you're doing with DD Amanda and keep us all abreast of how to use everything. That would be fantastic.
Thanks for having me, guys. You guys are awesome. You guys rock.
Anytime, sir. Okay, don't forget, STT Radio tomorrow, we have a big interview with the CEO of MDHI. That kicks off at 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Tomorrow night, a huge interview for the third time coming back on the radio program, the CEO of MIKP. Thursday morning, another stock spotlight brought to you by Mr. Haas. Thursday night, we have another CEO interview lined up. Can't mention that one, that ticker yet, but it will be out soon enough. Hope you enjoyed tonight's show. I found it very informative. I was, you know, I've used DD Amanda, and probably not to the extent Comp uses it, but I do use DD Amanda. I know Haas is a big fan of DD Amanda. Give it a try if you like it. You know, from what I see and from what I've heard from other people, you can't beat it. We want to thank you for listening to STT Radio. And as always, we're wishing you the best in all your trades, and may your portfolios always be green. This is Stock Traders Talk Radio, and we are out.
Aloha.
Are we out? Are we off?
Thank you for listening to Stock Traders Talk Radio.
Oh.
All views and topics talked about on Stock Traders Talk Radio is solely for entertainment purposes. We are not professional financial advisors and always recommend you seek the advice of a professional financial advisor. Never invest in any stock featured on our show unless you can afford to lose your entire investment. The information contained on our show is based on sources which we believe to be reliable, but is not guaranteed by us as being accurate, and might not be a complete statement or summary of the available data. Stock Traders Talk Radio advises that the investments in companies profiled are commonly considered to be high risk, and use of the information provided is at the investor's sole risk. Thank you for listening to Stock Traders Talk Radio.